I'm Tom Petersson, bass player for the group Cheap Trick. I'm here in London, England at 6060 Sound, Denmark Street. I came with our guitar player Rick Nielsen. He and I came to London in 1968. And we went to Cliff Cooper's shop, Orange Music, which it's around here somewhere, right? I don't know what the exact location was, and he was just starting to build Orange amps in the back room. So once the British invasion hit, that kind of took over everybody's lives at that time. And it just kept going on, and people are still listening to it. It's amazing. We first saw Orange amps being used by Fleetwood Mac. They came over, I think in 69 to the US, and they had the big giant bass rig, and you know, Peter Green and Danny Kirwan. I mean, the tone they had was just killer. So I love to have the feel of the air being pushed, like 4x12 cabinets. And, you know, I've always liked the sound of tube amps. I never liked transistors. It never had the right warmth to it and distortion. We don't use pedals. We don't use for distortion or anything. It's all total the amp being pushed to its maximum. It always, you want it, I mean, I love the sound of the amp sounding like it's about ready to blow up. I mean, like Jeff Beck, he's a perfect example of just this great tone. Of course, it's in his hands and everybody's, it's different in that way, but it's just that sound, that warmth and that real distortion that you can't get from, you know, transistor. You can't match the sound of tube amps. What I like about Orange is the quality of the gear and just the tone. It's got that warm tube sound, and you can push it. If you back off, it will clear up a bit, and it won't be, you know, it'll be relatively clean. And if you dig into it, it breaks up great. So you've got a lot of room with getting your own sound with muting and just your, you know, it brings all the subtleties out in your actual play. And it's just something about the sound of the analogue amps is unbeatable. For us, reliability is a big key, and you don't need amps breaking down or, you know, and having vintage amps and things, it's just a pain. You can't replace them, they get busted up traveling. And the Orange gear just covers all the bases, really. It's, you can get it everywhere, and they just have great sound. They're really unbeatable. There's really nothing better. The amps I use live, I use an AD50 guitar head running a 4x12 Orange cabinet, and an AD200 bass head running a 4x12 cabinet, and that's it. I play a 12-string bass. My rig is really the same for a 4-string as the 12-string bass. I don't change. It's that same guitar sound. It's really just, you're just adding in the high string. So it's a bit like a 12-string guitar playing along with a bass. It's really the, and when I switch over sometimes, a T-Bird or a Fender Precision, they both have that grand piano sound, which is great. So you get that great guitar distortion, and they've got great low end, and it's really basically the same sound. This is 12 strings, a bit bigger because there's so many more, there's, you know, high strings going on. Get the great guitar sound, and then just add bottom, and that's it. Nothing to it. The main reason, really, I think we keep going, or most musicians, is that you don't have a backup plan. You know, it's not like you can fall back on my lucrative dentistry career or something. There's nothing, you know, you're doing it. I've been doing this since I was 14 years old and started playing in clubs when I was about 15. And it's really basically all we know. It's what we love to do. And I can't imagine stopping. We weren't thinking, you're not thinking anything. You just doing it. You're just playing for the love of it. There's mainly no money in it, and no, you just do it because you just love it. And that's so we've kept going, and there's really no reason to stop yet.